I've known for some time. Little more than kids when we first met, but I always knew that she was fine. Streetwise and cool, this fly girl kept her head down in school. Sure, she was feisty and feisty, but she was nobody's fool. Intelligence in abundance may have led her to a little impatience, but when I look at her today, boy, she's come a long way since. Poetry is a form of self-expression without which I think I would probably be locked up somewhere by now. I was lucky to come into contact with poetry when I was very young. I saw Benjamin Zephaniah when I was about 12, and I was so inspired by this man getting up and talking about politics and things that were going on in the world that he was unhappy about. She's looking even better than I can ever remember. Developed a little control over the fiercest of tempers. Found direction and purpose to channel her mind without ever forgetting how to have a good time. I've got a piece in one of my books about, you know, why is it that a lyric can open a closed mind? And whether or not the fact that we spend so much time in our mother's wombs listening to a heartbeat is why we still love rhythms. All of these things are within poetry for me. I mean, I love Shakespeare, I love anything which has got rhythm. And so poetry for me, it's kind of like... Okay, so my name is Mark Mr. T. Thompson, and this is Cultural Chameleon. I am a cultural chameleon, a lyrical social comedian. I felt I had no choice but to change my voice to appear average by mean, mode, or medium. I studied hard to fit in and be cool for as long as I've been able to speak. Although, not to stand out of my school, I had to learn a little common, not Latin or Greek. Me have to pick up my patois in conversation and in academia too, because if you're not first generation, it might not come naturally to you. I've delved deep in all sides of my history, something I believe every person should do. Because if where you come from is a mystery, can you be sure that your heading is true? So to stories of Romans and Boudicca, I add Maroons, Garvey, and Shaka Zulu, and ensure the light of the Lady of the Lamp never obscures Mary Seacole from view. My biological heritage is both black and British, and yet some really do seem to feel that my need to pay sums to both these cultural clubs is somehow less than real. Like some BNP or National Front, jumped up front, sound up and ain't no pal in front, ignorant grunt, I want to sort of go back to our geographically correct historical homes. Well, mine spread by over 5 hours of time, and that's a little harder to straddle than a couple of travel card zones. Forget that this patriot's queen is Franco-German. The suggestion of this lunatic is the place I should feel most at home in is floating somewhere over the mid-Atlantic. One time, down in London town, the other in Kingston, poor rich. Better put me on the rack right now, come and let them just won't stretch. My little savings went upon my breakfast, see? When me right size just had me lunch. I guess if I'm confused, stuck in between, I could always just do brunch. But from that lofty spot, I could appreciate many artists that have shaped our current worldview. Great bards from Tuff Gong to Billy Wagadagga, known as Marley and Shakespeare to you. The Windrush might appear through time's mystery as it answered the mother country's call. Those abhorred and bowed by their history, each with the right to stand proud and tall. Slave routes back to Africa would be visible too, a journey so many did not survive. Britannia's involvement is shameful, it's true, but I'm so proud that I am alive, for my DNA's very existence is a testimony to my ancestors' persistence and my parents' tolerance. Even when surrounded by overwhelming ignorance, it is a unique blend of Aboriginal British bloodlines and those of the invited immigrants. So yes, I am a cultural chameleon, a lyrical social chameleon, and now, by choice, I change my voice to appear more than average by mean, mode, or medium.